We're looking at the 2595 LM Garmin GPS, a very popular tool for navigating. It got replaced by the smartphone, which had its built-in capability for GPS and mapping. So why in 2023 should we even consider using an old Garmin or other device? Well, it's true that the smartphone can navigate. It also can do a multitude of other things. So the question is, do you want to spend a long drive staring at your phone mapping? Or would you rather have a dedicated device that does that for you? Well, you can use this for its many other functions. Your smartphone relies on cell towers, which sometimes can be out of range, whereas the GPS relies on satellites. To update any Garmin, simply download Garmin Express. It's available for free. Run the application and it will download the map into your GPS. Now, if the memory on your GPS is limited, it'll allow you to select a region. That's the case we have here, which is why our map is up to date, but I actually want the entire US. So I'm gonna go into map details, more options. I'm gonna tell it to change map, accept the agreement, continue, and then I get this message that it's recommending that I either choose only a region or that I add more memory. To update the memory, you're gonna have to purchase a micro SD. Recommended is 2 gigabytes, but you can go all the way up to 32 gigabytes, which is the max the unit can handle. I'm gonna recommend that you get a 32 gigabyte micro SD, only because they're about $5-6 right now, so they're extremely cheap, and as their maps grow in size, you'll have the expanded memory to use. This is the micro SD that I purchased. It just happens to come with an SD adapter, which is nice, but not needed for our application. It just happened to be something that was on sale, so I picked this one up. With the micro SD out of the package, we are ready to find where it goes on the GPS. So on the top, we have power supply switch. Nothing on this side, nothing on the back, nothing on the bottom, one side left, and oh, there it is. Right there is the micro SD card. So all you do is you push down on it, if there's one in there. In my case, there is. And then you pull out the card. Now notice that when you pull it out, the copper tabs are on the back side. So you want to put it in the same way. So we put ours down, grab the new one, copper's on the back, and then we just insert, push it all the way down, and you should feel a click, and it should be below the surface. If it's slightly protruding, then it hasn't gone all the way in. With that done, we're ready to continue with the map update. Also note that not all Garmin GPSs have their micro SD slot on the left-hand side. On this one, it's on the bottom. But again, it's the same procedure where you push down on the card, if there's one in there, and then you lift it out. And in this case, the copper strips are facing towards the back of the unit, so you would drop your replacement card the same way. Press in until it catches, then you're set to update. With the Garmin reconnected to the computer, we select continue on use a memory card. What? It's incompatible? If you get an error message saying the memory is incompatible, hit try again and it should find the card. At this point, you can hit continue. Then the program will proceed with updating the map. In my case, I have a leftover micro SD, which I can now repurpose thanks to the adapter that came with my new card. When the download's completed, simply unplug the GPS, switch it on, confirm the agreement, and you're ready to go. If you found this video interesting or useful, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, join the subscription team, And as always, thank you ever so much for watching.